Hello and welcome to a new tutorial. Today we are talking about motion sketch. This is a feature that is in After Effects that you can draw the path for your animation. Let's see how it works. So I have two objects here. I have a car with PNG transparency and I have this track, and I'll use this track as my go-to track for I can do my animation. What you need to do is get window, you get motion sketch, and you have this window here, and it says capture speed at 100, smoothing will be for the curve that you're gonna do, show wireframe and show background. You're gonna activate this so that we can see the track and we want our car to go along. So we'll scale the car down like this, and I'll put the car over here. It doesn't really matter that the car is at that side because we're going to do something to it so it will follow the animation. What you need to do is just grab the car and you want to just go with your mouse again here, or you could use a pen tool, for example, like a Wacom to do this. But what I'll do is, for 14 seconds, this is the duration of my composition. If you want to change, go to composition setting. You change the composition settings. In this case, I'll just put 10 seconds. Just that's enough for the animation. And I'll press OK. And you can see here the duration, it's 10 seconds. So now what I'll do is I'll start capture and I'll grab the car and I'll do this. I'll go around the track. And there we go. So what happens is that motion sketch, the smoothing, as you can see, there's a lot of points. If you want to make better, you put more smoothing, like let's say 86, and I'll start capture and I'll go about it like this. And now you can see that the line is much smoother than it was before. But the one thing is you have to know the timing that you're drawing, because you might speed up in the end and that way you could get like not equal animation. So what I would recommend is even give more time so you have more time for the animation. So let's say composition seconds, I want 10 seconds, but what I'll do is I'll just put 30 seconds so I have more than enough time to do my animation, and I can increase these. Then I'll do the start capture in the beginning, I'll grab the car, I'll start capture, and then I go about here, and the speed, it's fine. Okay, here we go. We have our line, and now we can see our animation of our car. You can see it goes up to, actually, I think I finished almost at 10 seconds. But what I can do now is I can press the U key and I have my animation, and I can see how fast it goes and has these points. You can see my smoothing was too smooth. So I'll start over. Smoothing, I'll put like, I don't know, 20. Now I'll start capturing. Okay, here we go. So we have our line and you can see all the animation. So if it is too fast, if you go to the graphic, you can see the position. If you select the speed graph, you can see the variation of the speed. So you just have to tweak this to put always at the same speed. If you want the car, just go around like that. But now all we need to do so that the car follow the track is just right click on the car, go to transform, auto orient, and it will pop up this window. All you have to do is orient along path, and you can see the car is now driving, but it's backwards, no problem. We go to rotation and just rotate the correct way. So now we have our car driving away in our track. And you'll see that it'll speed up sometimes, like here it speeds up, that's fine. What you need to do, you go to position, you see the speed graph, and you click on the line. And if you just drag it like this, you'll see that you're going to set up all at the same speed. You might want to select all of them first, maybe make them longer. You should start over at the second one, so you always fit the first part. Okay, that's pretty much at the same speed, almost everyone. Okay, so now it's pretty much always at the same speed. Once we do this, if you finish everything and now it's always at the same speed, you can drag them all and just make them faster to the 10 seconds, and now you have your car driving in 10 seconds the whole track. So this was the tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.